welcome to the American Heart Association's Tucson Heart and Stroke Walk digital experience. I'm Steve Pangburn.
And I'm Susanna Pangburn, and we're proud to be your chairs for this year's Heart and Stroke Walk. Thank you for your support of the American Heart Association. Steve and I are so passionate about their mission. We also support this cause because of our own personal experience. Our son Lincoln was born with the same congenital heart condition as my father. Lincoln underwent life-saving heart surgery as a newborn, but today he's a 10-year-old, healthy, happy boy. And we owe that to the advancements in medical research supported by the American Heart Association.
The Heart Walk is a time for our community to come together and encourage each other to move more. While we aren't together in person, we can still encourage each other from our own homes and neighborhoods. We want you to get outside to walk, ride, or play today. We all need about 30 minutes of activity a day to keep our hearts healthy. Get moving, because any activity counts.
We also want to take a moment to thank all the companies that support the American Heart Association. And to these sponsors, we want to say thank you so much.
We're about to head out now for our family walk. When you're out, take a photo and share it with the hashtag TUCHeartWalk.
But first, let's hear from Kyle, who is so inspired by today that it sparked his amazing weight loss journey.
I think a lot of people struggle with the same thing that I do, and it's how do you stay in shape if you have such a sedentary job? I was at my absolute heaviest October 2020 at 430 pounds. My issues were compounded. The reason I was gaining so much weight so quickly was not just because of the sedentary lifestyle, but because I was diagnosed with hypothyroidism. Something just kind of went, and I instantly broke down and just started crying. I immediately had this clarity, you know, and it just all became so simple. I'm the hero of this story, okay? All I have to do is realize it. I had never walked that far, probably since I was in college. Even though I hurt, even though I was exhausted, even though I was freezing cold, I sat there sweaty, bloody, tired as hell on the front porch, and I smiled bigger than I can ever remember smiling. And I looked at my brother and I said, "This is it. There's no going back. I'm not going back to that guy." You're already walking 5 miles every single day at this point. Why don't you just ask people to donate to what would have killed you had you not started doing this? In return, at the end of that 5 miles, I make a video telling you thank you for your donation. Thank you for pushing me to be a better man, pushing me to be healthy, pushing me to not have to have someone save my life because I have a heart attack. Got so many things that I've always wanted to do that are so rapidly becoming possible for me. I stopped teaching myself how to play guitar. I picked that back up. I love to sing. I've always wanted to go kayaking. Always wanted to go snowboarding. I will go snowboarding. And guess what? I'm going to be doing it in the Rockies or something. And the reason for that is because I'm going to travel. I no longer say, "I'm thinking about doing this," or "I might do this," or "maybe this," "maybe tomorrow." No, if I say that I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. And there's nothing that's going to stop me.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5,